So, like I say, we are interested to find some new Sbox or some Sbox that can be efficiently implemented in hardware and particularly in threshold manner. And threshold implementation has really useful to be resistant against side channel attacks. So let me start what it is side channel attacks, what is the side channel attacks model. In the black box model, we have our adversary that makes some request to some black box oracle, and he have to do some computation, and he have to make a lot of time before he recovers the key. In the side channel model, we allow the adversary to observe the device that implement the algorithm. And this device will require some time, some power consumption to perform the operation. Then if the adversary monitors this through an oscilloscope, it will obtain some traces. And with the help of the traces, now we know since the late 90s that key recovery can be really practical. So to counter such channel attack, a command countermeasure is to use masking. So on the left part, I represent what happened in the unprotected cases. We have our device that implemented the start of, for example, the AES. I have my plaintext X that I XOR with my key K, and I apply the Sbox. And since my device used some small bit of the key for the Sbox, I can perform some exhaustive search on the value Y and mount an attack. The idea of masking is to use secret sharing. And then I don't have my secret, but now I would share my secret in several parts. And then if my masking is correctly implemented, I have to guess value, different value, and that is more complex to mount an attack. And in particular, we have a theorem in masking that says the number of traces needed to mount an attack will grow exponentially with the number of shares that we use in the implementation and with the noise as a basis. As we saw yesterday, for this theorem to hold, we need to have some enough noise on each shares. Other condition we need is that our randomness is unpredictable and uniform. And finally, we have some physical assumption that says that our device doesn't combine different shares. That is the independence of leakage, and it can be defect in software due to transition or in hardware due to glitches. And to have masking in hardware, a command countermeasure is to use threshold implementation. So in the threshold implementation, I have my function f, and I will also use some shared function. And so what I want for threshold implementation is the correctness. Basically, if I use the shared function on the shared input, I should obtain the same result when I open my shared output as if I apply the function on the input. The second condition is the non-completeness, and that is for resistance against first order attack. And that says that each subcircuit should be independent of at least one shares. If it is independent of one shares, it's independent of the secret, as I need all the shares to recover the secret. And then whatever happened in this function, it will be independent of the secret. And finally, we need a third condition that is called uniformity. And what that means is that the shared output should have the same form, should have the same distribution if I calculate from Z1, Z2, Z3 through F, or if I just share Y. And this can be difficult to achieve in when we want to have a threshold implementation. So sometimes we just add some randomness to obtain a uniform sharing. Due to the non-completeness, we can see that if my function f is of degree t, I will need to have t plus one shares. As we can see, we will have to compute some monomial of degree t, And due to the non-completeness, I will have to have at least D plus one shares. So the idea to reduce the number of shares needed is to use algebraic decomposition of the function, and I represent my function f as a composition of two functions. And now I can just share the first function and the second function. I have the non-completeness, I have the uniformity, so I can reuse the output directly, but I have to stop the glitches, so I have to put some register in between. So that leads us to different techniques to implement the function, and basically I will talk about two different techniques. The first one is some raw implementation, where these registers are for the input of the different S-box, and then I have the function, the shared function, and I have my register to stop the glitches, and each clock cycle I will move off one, and then in the number n plus the number of function, I will compute all my S-boxes. That is nice, and we can always do that. But we can also have the second type of implementation. If the function we use to perform the composition is the same, and then I would just have to implement once my function f and use some multiplexer to say if it's not the number of round of composition of my function, I keep the same input, and at some point I would input the second input. So this can lead to really small implementation, but we will need more clock cycle to perform our S-box. So what I've been done here for S-box in threshold implementation, we have there is a nice paper at CHESS 2012 that look at our threshold implementation for 3 and 4 bit permutation. And a particular result of this paper is that among the different affine classes of S-box, 35 can be easily shared in threshold manner. And what I mean that efficient in threshold is that we just have to use 3 shares, no extra randomness, and we have at most 2 stages, the composition of 2 functions. Another approach to look at threshold implementation for S-box is to take S-box that have good cryptographic property and try to find some nice threshold implementation. So a lot of effort have been done for the AES, as it is a standard, and there are different trade-off between the space of the S-box, the number of randomness needed, the number of shares, etc. And there is also some more friendly S-box as used in FIDES or KCHAC, but that use smaller number of bits. And finally, the question we have when we saw this result is, can we have some 8-bit S-box with good cryptographic property, maybe not as good as the AES one, but still decent, and can they have some really efficient threshold implementation? So our idea is to say we have the result for all 4-bit S-box. Can we use this to have a threshold implementation of 8-bit S-box? And actually, in the literature, a lot of cipher use small S-boxes to build larger S-boxes. That is the case of Clefia, Krypton, Fantomas, Iceberg, etc. And among all these cipher, just one of them can be implemented in an iterative manner. So that is nice. We have some nice threshold implementation, but can we obtain some better results, some better S-box with similar cryptographic property as this S-box, but that can be take advantage of iterative implementation. So we launched some search, and we first look at function based on the substitution permutation network, and in that case, I will use some S-box F1, F2 on 4-bit, then apply some affine transformation, and I can add some constant as the key addition. So this is the structure used for Iceberg, Hazard, and Wirepool. And if I want to enumerate all S-box of this form, I have 16 factorial choice for F1, 16 factorial choice for F2, and that is too much. So to reduce the cost of the search, we say, anyway, we want to have some efficient implementation iteration. So we just have to look at to the 35 cases that are particularly efficient to mask. And then we look at different cases for affine transformation and also for the constant. And then we have a set of 2^32 S boxes. So I will run our search. I will show the result after. But first, let's look at the second construction, that is Festal network. So Festal network, we just have one function, and each input are 4 bits. And this is a structure used for Robin and Scream in particular. And there is some mathematical proof on the bound of cryptographic result we can obtain up to 3 rounds. So we know what we can have, but if we do more rounds, maybe we can have better result. Two remarks about Festal networks. The first one is that whatever the function is, even if it's not a permutation, due to the Festal structure, I will obtain a permutation. And the second remark is that as I XOR the right input to the output of my function F1, if I can compute F1 in a threshold manner in one cycle, I will obtain automatically a uniform sharing on the 8 bits. And that gives us uniformity for free. And now the number of choice is all the function from 4-bit to 4-bit, and this is 2^64. So we try to reduce this search space, and what we found is that we have functions can be defined in affine classes, that basically F1 is affine to F, is in the same classes of F, if there exists A and B to F in permutation and C a linear map, mapping, suggest F1 it's equal at the composition of B by F by A plus C. So this is nice, but it don't reduce the search space. What we can look at, it's at one function of the form A minus 1 F A. And if I write my one function like that, I can also rewrite it as applying A minus 1 to both input, then do a Festal run with just only F, and then apply A to the both output. And if I compose this function, my A minus, A minus 1 and A will cancel out. And then what I obtain is A minus 1, Festal of F and A. And that is affine equivalent, and in particular, has the same cryptographic property of Festal of F. So we don't have to look at all functions of this form. We can just look at function of form F composed by A, and we can add the linear mapping C, and then we reduce the cost to 2^46, and to do our search, we use graphic process unit. So what are the cryptographic properties we want for our S-box? First, we want a bijection, but for SPN, we look at permutation component, so we will have a permutation in any case, and for the Festal network, we have this due to the behavior of Festal network. Then we want our S-box to have to be nonlinear or as most nonlinear as possible. So that means we don't want to have a linear approximation of the function. We look also at differential of uniformity. That means if I put a differential input on my S-box, it should be difficult to predict the differential I should observe on the output. And we also look at algebraic degree. So let's go to the result I represent in the table. In our paper, we have a larger table with more S-boxes and more criteria. If you are interested in this, I highly encourage you to look at it. But just to show some more nice results, so the first column is for the different S-box that we look at. Then we have the different cryptographic property. And in that case, the IIS S-box is the best S-box we know up to today. And we don't find any S-box that is better than the IIS, not surprisingly. And that we found some that are similar value as S-box that are used in the literature. And then we have the threshold figures that basically is the area, and if we can use iterative implementation or raw implementation. And basically, due to our, as we use the same run function, our new S-box can be done in an iterative manner. And what we can see is that we have some really small implementation when we look at iterative implementation. We have also the number of stages, that is basically the number of clock cycles we need to perform one S-box, and that is also the number of registers we need to have. And there is a number of masks that have been used to obtain uniformity, and that is only for the AS we need to have this. So there is some nice S-box that are less good as the AS S-box, but that can be implemented efficiently in threshold. And finally, we have the type of the function. So what we can see from this table is that we have interesting trade-off for good cryptographic S-box. And in particular, we can see that the S-box we found, if we compare to what we can find in the literature, have smaller threshold implementation, even if we degrade or security requirement. And finally, due to our exhaustive search on Festel network, we have this side result that say there exists no 8-bit Festel network with the identity, with the same run function. And if we iterate up to 5 rounds, we can have something better than as before. So that is the same as WirePool. That is somehow interesting for some people. And then, so what is the takeoff message of this paper? What you should read it is because we have a large set of S-box that we present that can be really easily implemented in threshold manner. Our S-box are also really efficient when we want to implement in an unprotected manner in hardware, and maybe some other interesting result is that the function ASB2 that have the same cryptographic property as Robin and Scream have also the same number of AND gate, and that is of particular interest when we look at the software bit slice implementation. So we can have this S-box that can be both efficiently implemented in a threshold manner, but also for software masking, and that is nice, I think. So that concludes my talk, and if you have any question, please ask.